The State Minister for Planning, Amos Lugoloobi, has visited Entebbe International Airport Free Zone, which is still under construction, to ascertain the progress of the construction works so far. During the inspection tour, the minister commended Uganda Free Zone's authority on the construction works so far done in developing the first public free zone, optimistic that once completed, it will give a boost to the country's exports.
To see that we negotiate those agreements where we have double taxation effects in order to be able to attract investors, because it makes no sense for an investor to be taxed here, and then it's taxed there in another country. That erodes profitability of those enterprises. So I think what we need to do is renegotiate those agreements and see at a bilateral level how we can sort out.
Uganda's share of exports in the global market is relatively low at the moment, but with infrastructure such as the Entebbe International Airport Free Zone, Minister Lugoloobi explains that the country's exports will be able to compete favorably in the regional, continental and international markets. Lugoloobi, however, expressed the need for private entities to be enticed to occupy the government free zones through setting up more factories.
We do not invest in export development. I think that is the message we need to carry home so that the policymakers really appreciate this. That if you want to create jobs, you want to grow this economy, we really need to look in the direction of exports. And the other thing is that it is through this export processing that we shall utilize the raw materials that are being produced, you know, in those rural areas. So what we are going to be producing, this is just part of a long value chain, beginning in the villages where people are producing, and then it can be processed here.
According to the executive director of the Uganda Free Zones Authority, Hezi Kimoomi Alinda, the multi-billion project will not only grow exports, but will also employ scores of Ugandans.
Employing directly about 200 people, directly, and indirectly about 600 people. We're expecting it to augment exports to a tune of about $4 million per annum. We are also expecting additional private sector investment of about $13.4 million for their machinery and other equipment that will be coming in, given that we are focusing on cold storage and a few other things that enable agricultural products, special agricultural products, fruits, vegetables, flowers, high-value mineral beneficiation, and other investments.
By the closure of this financial year, the project will be substantially completed, according to Alinda. Kimoomi, however, reported a huge shortfall in the funds needed to expedite the completion works of this facility, citing the need for more 8.3 billion shillings.
BOQs were about 46.6 billion shillings. Because of the release of funds in bits and pieces, we have had a cost increase to about 60 billion shillings. So this project is now the latest BOQs that we have. Overall, including the land, the supervision, the construction, 60.157 billion. So far, government has released 46.657 billion shillings for the works that we are seeing here.
Upon completion, the free zone will have farms engaged in high-value mineral processing activities, light manufacturing and agro-processing for export through Entebbe International Airport. Free zones are designated areas that provide a transnational business environment outside the country's customs territory in an effort to encourage domestic manufacturing and value-added investment. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.